Morning. Today I was making a video for you to do another reverse dip, and that didn't work out, and I'll show you why in a minute. But first I will show you the previous reverse dip, the first one I did. I was really disappointed. I hope you can see it, but it totally cracked, and I think that was maybe because of the enamel, the satin enamel, or maybe because I wetted my paper towel too much. I don't know. And all the colors, well, they disappeared in the black, I guess. And yeah, the white diluted it, so I am totally not happy with this. So I wanted to do another one, and well, what happened is that I didn't like what I was doing. So first I got this, then I got this, and then when I was finally totally fed up with it, I got this. And that was just by, well, throwing some paint on the canvas and a little lot of white. And that is the one I actually like best, because I like the a lot of negative space, and this is a little bit more abstract, and I really like that. So I am going to try to replicate something like that. I'm using an orange, I'm using magenta, I'm using a lemon yellow, and I'm using a vermilion red, and I'm using white. Okay, what I'm going to do now is first I'm going to throw some paints in the middle, just some blobs here and there. That's what I did when I was fed up. I just put down some paints because I was sick of looking at the ruined painting. I know it looks like a lot, but that's what I did because I just wanted to empty my cups. And now I'm just doing a lot of white around it. I know it's on really thick, but that's the way I did it. So I'm just doing that again. Just moving the white around a little. Making sure it's going over the sides. So I hope I can do this again to show you. I guess Fiona and Gemma are really the queens of laying down the dots and make beautiful flowers with it. I'm just not made for it. Go away. Okay, now I'm going to wet this paper towel, but not as much as I did last time. Just a couple of sprays, light spraying. And I'm putting it over the paint now. So I hope that I can do this again, because I think the last result looked really pretty. Okay, here we go, guys. Just catching the corners and pulling it up carefully. And I guess it worked again. Now I'm just spreading it out a little bit and pushing some whites off the sides, You see now I made a large orange petal. I don't want that, so I will just put some white over that again. And I will just swipe that off very lightly. So, now there's some orange coming through. Just a minute. Okay, now it's gone. And what I'm going to do now is I will torch it a little bit. Get the air bubbles out. We can get some reaction. Yeah, we get a little, I guess in one of my paints there must be a little bit of silicone. But I like this a lot better. And what I will do at last, I will dip my glob, my blowing up glob, in the middle to create some kind of a center, I hope. Yeah, that worked. And I like it just the way it is now. I don't like it when it's very busy. I guess I'm more of an abstract girl. So I really hope it will dry like this. I know my paint is on really thick, but normally I never have issues with cracking. So there's no enamel in it now. So I think it will turn out just fine. But I will show you, of course, in a later video how they turned out. Because the other one was still wet as well. Okay guys, I'm going to give you a close-up and I hope you like this really short video, but I cannot make anything more about this. Oh, I can see there's a little bit of orange here. Just picking up some white paint and get that over the sides. But I guess our taste is all different. Maybe some of you like my first result better, but this is just the way I like it. And maybe you actually don't. But that's fine. I'm glad we're not all the same. And well, I hope some of you will try this this too. I just want to show you everything and also my failures and my successes, because I think I like everybody to learn, and well, this makes me so happy. And I just want that for you too, guys. I want everybody to feel happy and get joyful because of all the pretty colors, and well, that's how I feel, and that's what I wish for everybody. So, okay, I will torch this one more time. Good torch from high up above. And that's it. Okay, guys, I will show you the close-up. Okay, here I am again. Oh, by the way, this canvas is just a little one, a 20 by 20. And that are always my practice canvases, because last time I used a 30 by 30. Well, that didn't turn out great, as you saw. So I'm trying to give you a close up. I think this looks really pretty. Maybe it's not really a flower, but I just like it this way. And I hope you do too. We don't actually see a lot of the magenta, only here at the sides. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video and well, maybe you have learned something. I actually did. I know now that I'm actually way more about the abstract things than the really busy things. And well, I'm glad I discovered I can do it like this. Just throw some paint on, put a lot of white around it, and then dip. I will be doing this with other colors and maybe again on a black background to see if maybe then I can hold my colors better. And well, I hope you will be with me again next time. So thank you for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.